Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to Muhammad Sheikh's channel. Please click the bell icon so that you may receive timely notifications of our upcoming videos.
Surah Al-Baqarah 2 and Ayah 213. كَانَ النَّاسُ أُمَّةً وَاحِدًا فَبَعَثَ اللَّهُ النَّبِيِّينَ مُبَشِّرِينَ وَمُنذِرِينَ وَأَنزَلَ مَعَهُمُ الْكِتَابَ بِالْحَقِّ لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ فِيمَا اخْتَلَفُوا فِيهِ. Mankind is one single ummah, nation, and Allah appointed Nabiyeen, prophets, to give good news and warnings, and with them He revealed Al-Kitab, the book, in truth, to govern between mankind in what they differed in it. So Allah says that mankind, kana nasu ummatan wahida, mankind is one single nation, faba'atha Allah Nabiyeen, Allah appointed prophets. Now, I hold in my hand is a book, the book Al-Kitab. And the prophets, if you note, is in plural. The Arabic is An-Nabiyyin is a plural. The point here is that the prophets were given the book Al-Kitab. This book Al-Kitab, we have already discussed that what is this book, what it contains. Now we are discussing this book was given to whom? To whom this book was given? This book I'm talking about. I'm talking about Al-Kitab now. Because ayat is, we have previously ayat for Al-Kitab. Now we are reading Al-Kitab, the book. So this book, Allah says, mankind is all times, in all times, in past, in present, future. Mankind is one single nation. It means every mankind has got way the same psyche. We may be programmed into different schools of thoughts, but basic cycle is the same. One single nation. Allah appointed prophets in plural. And they came to give good news and warn. And with these prophets, Allah says, we reveal the book singular, Al-Kitab, the book, with truth in haq, bil-haq. So this is for a simple person who have been not programmed into four books, may read this and understand. It's not a difficult part to understand.
We all know that Quran is in Arabic language. And this book is for all time. Then my question is, what were the languages of the prophets, like Moses, like Jesus? What language they spoke?
Okay, actually this, we have just now read that the book is, we are talking, we are reading the book again, and this is all Arabic we are reading, this book. If this book was the same in all time, so this becomes the Arabic language. But your question is, what was the language of the prophets? That is their question, what was the language? Because in the Christian world, according to the Bible and Moses, they spoke Hebrew. Jesus spoke Hebrew and Moses spoke Hebrew. According to the Jews and Christians, this is what they say. But when we read in the ayahs, the Quran says, وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَىٰ يَا قَوْمِ, and Allah says, when Musa said, O my people, so Allah is not translating Hebrew into Arabic. Allah is translating about the Musa in Arabic. And when Isa says, قَالَ اللَّهُ يَا إِسَىٰ, no, when he says, وَإِذْ قَالَ إِسَىٰ بْنُ مَرْيَمَ يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ, so Isa Islam is speaking in Arabic. So Musa Islam is speaking in Arabic. Nuh Islam is speaking in Arabic in the ayahs. So Allah is not translating them into Arabic and giving us the book. So all the messengers was speaking Arabic according to ayahs. But now what has happened, first I will explain to you what, there is a different topic about languages also, but in, I will explain to you 2-3 ayahs to explain to you how the message was explained in the world, even there were different languages. First of all, our room 30 and ayah 22. The ayah says, وَمِنْ آيَاتِ خَلْقُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافُ أَلْسِنَتِكُمْ وَأَلْوَانِكُمْ إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِلْعَالِمِينَ. And from his ayahs, sign is the creation of the skies and the earth, and the difference of your languages and your colors. Surely in that are ayahs, signs for those who know. So in this ayat, Allah is saying that Allah has created different languages and different colors. These are the signs or the ayahs of Allah. So there is nobody in the whole world who can claim that I created Urdu language, or I am the creator of English language, or I am the creator of any other language. So it is the ayahs or the sign that we people have different colors. white, black, yellow, whatever colors, and different languages of the world are the signs or the eyes of Allah. So that means all the languages, including Arabic, is all Allah has created the languages. So nobody can own or nobody can say he's the author of a different language. So all languages are by Allah's creation, and Allah's languages and colors are Allah's ayah signs. Now the revelation that came to us in Arabic is mentioned surah, other places, but I'm giving you one reference, Ashura 26, 192 to 196. نزل به روح الأمين على قلبك لتكون من المنذرين بلسان عربي مبين وإنه لفي زبر الأولين. And surely it is a revelation from the Lord of the worlds. Revealed with it is the spirit of truth over your heart, so you become from the warners with the clear Arabic tongue, Arabic language. And surely it is in the earlier pieces. Now in this ayat, if you will note, that Allah says that the revelation that came down is from the Lord of the worlds. Revealed with is the spirit of truth. Nazala bihirul amin. Ala qalbika, over your heart. Litakuna min al-muzdin, so that you may warn. That is referring to Muhammad Rasulullah. Bi lisanin arabi mubin, with the Arabic language. So that means the revelation that came to the messengers was with the Arabic language on the heart of messenger. Muhammad Rasulullah, that is in Arabic language. But to explain to the people, it is referred in Surah Ibrahim 14 and Ayah 4. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا بِلِسَانِ قَوْمِهِ لِيُبَيِّنَ لَهُمْ فَيُضِلُّ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. We have not sent from any messenger except with the language of his people in order to clarify for them. So Allah leaves training those whom He pleases and guide those whom He pleases. And He is exalted and power, full of wisdom. In this ayat, Allah is telling us that Allah has sent messengers. We have read all these ayat, Allah sent messengers and they were all speaking in Arabic language. But to clarify to the people, it is in the language of the people. So He says, we have not sent from the messenger except with the language of His people. So the messenger knew the language of the people. The revelation that came down was Arabic. We just now read with the Arabic language. But they also knew the language of the people. So the messenger explained people in the language of the people. And today also, the practice in the whole world is, whether now I am speaking in English with you. Right now I am speaking in English. But at the same time, this ayat is in Arabic, translated in English, and the explanation is in English. So all of parts in Urdu also, maybe in German also, somebody will maybe explain in German language, somebody is explaining Chinese language, or somebody is explaining any other language. So in all time, the messengers has been explaining people in the people's language. And people in this today world, we people are following the example and the footsteps of the messenger by trying to understand first the Arabic text, and then translate and explain to the people in the language of the people. So all the time the message is understood by people in their own language.